I'm standing in a boxing gymnasium in the old Kent Road, London, very much like one a 13-year-old boy once walked into. He was so inspired by what he saw that he decided to combine boxing with the martial arts he was already practicing. This young fellow made the gym his school, and after hours of self-tuition and endless practice, he graduated to world championship status. He was motivated by martial arts and boxing greats, the most significant of whom still give him endless inspiration. From this background emerged a champion possessing a unique style and approach to semi-contact fighting. He's won no less than 3 world light heavyweight titles, 3 European championships, and countless US and UK majors. In the latter part of the 1980s, he's become one of the most exciting and sought-after champions these countries have ever seen. I'm speaking, of course, of Kevin Brewerton. This is the first in a series of training videos that will show you what it takes to reach the top as Kevin takes you through his school toward graduation.
Hi, well, welcome to my first video. Let me take you through School of Champions. Right here, it's like a second home. In fact, it is a home to me. It's been a home for a long time now. And what I like to do is take you through some of the formats that I use when I prepare for major competition. So first of all, I get in the gym, I pick up the skipper rope, because skipping is a great way of warming up. Let's go. You know, the thing about skipping is, not a lot of people do it. You'll find that it is fantastic for coordination, particularly in martial arts, where you have to coordinate your hands and your feet all of the time. So it's very important. Use the rope as much as you can. It helps with coordination vastly. And while you skip, try a whole bunch of different things, like moving side to side, like picking up alternate knees, like jumping, double rope. All of this is good. Gives you that variation. So you can step up a gear for stamina, and you can take it down. So everything relates to a competition. You take it down in a tournament, and you pick it up. Everything relates. Okay, now the thing to remember about skipping is this. Whilst you're skipping, say you time yourself for a 6-minute or 8-minute skipping period. In that time, what you have to do is you gotta section it off. Say you're skipping for a 6-minute period. Say the first minute, you go at a regular pace. And 30 seconds after that, you'll work at high rate. Then you'll go back into regular pace. Another 30 seconds, you go on a double pace and step it up a gear. That's what you got to do. So you sequence it off and you section it. Then you go 15 seconds of double jumps. Then you go 15 seconds of backward and forth. Then 15 seconds of side to side. Then to regular pace again. And then you put it all together. Until at the end of the 6 minutes, you feel like you've been through a hell of a workout. And the fact is, you've only just begun. Okay. Okay, there's a warm-up, 6, 8, 10, 12 minutes of skipping. It's entirely up to you. If you're new, take your time. It could be a little too demanding. Pace it out. Consistency, 10 minutes a day, 8, 25, 30 minutes of skipping. It's entirely up to you.